Visit to Eco Home in Surat, Gujarat, India. Let us have a look at some of the points incorporated in this house to make it eco-friendly. This piece of land was not having a single tree 20 years back, and now there are more than 600 trees of 120 varieties. All the trees grown in this premises are selected in such a way that they provide food for birds, bees, and butterflies. Solar and wind power is used to electrify the house. 8 kilowatt of power is generated from rooftop solar panels and wind turbine. The angle of roof is designed in such a way that the panels can be directly fitted on them. Battery bank is used to store power. A rooftop solar power is used to charge the electric car. All lighting in this house is with LED for minimum power consumption and electrical gadgets with high efficiency rating. There are large windows in all the rooms to use natural light. This house has rooftop water harvesting system. Rainwater is collected from roof in water tanks kept on the first floor for directly using on ground floor living area without using the power to pump the water back to the overhead water tank. Excess rainwater from the first floor rainwater storage tank is diverted to groundwater tanks of 2 lakh liters capacity. It is filtered through sand, gravel, and charcoal before it reaches these tanks. From here, it is pumped to freshwater tank on the top of the house, and this water is used throughout the year. After the rainwater tanks get full, excess water is diverted into the ground. Bathroom, wash basin, and shower water is collected separately and passed through 3-tub root bed treatment. Here, in the first tub, Kenna plants are grown in sand. In second tub, water hyacinth and duckweed plants are kept, and in the third tub, umbrella and lily plants are grown. There are fish in the water to keep mosquitoes away, and their staying alive also indicates that there is enough oxygen in water which is used for growing organic vegetables. Washing machine water is collected in a separate tank, and from here it goes to all the toilet flush. Black water from toilet flush is sent to settling tank, where solid settles down and water coming out from there goes to reed bed for aerobic cleansing and then to organic garden. The windmill pumps water from well for use in the garden. All the walls are cavity walls of exposed bricks to keep heat out in the summer, and it also prevents inside heat from going out in winter. No paint and plastering is done on the walls, so volatile emissions are avoided in the house. The length of chhajjas projecting out of the walls are designed to keep direct sunlight out of the house in summer, and in winter sunlight enters inside the house. Thus, natural air conditioning effect is achieved. A water body is designed between living area and sleeping area, and this also helps in keeping the surroundings cool. The water body has fish and lilies to keep the water clean. Three-chamber plant and sand-based water filter is also built at one of the end of the pond. All bedrooms has windows on three sides for having good cross ventilation. Solar water heater with hot water recirculation system is used so that the water is not wasted. Kota stone is used for flooring and black and yellow stone for walls, which are available locally. Ceramic, granite tiles, and Italian marble need a lot of energy for manufacturing and transportation. Hence, they are avoided. The sloping roof of the house is designed in such a way that the rising hot air goes out from the top and cool air enters from the bottom. Also, fans are provided at low level in windows to suck in cool air from outside, and exhaust fans are provided on top side near roof to push hot air out. Special air cooling pipes are run through ground floor water tank area just above the water level with outlets in the room with fan at the end of the pipe. Air enters the pipe at atmospheric temperature and cools down as it passes above cold water. Creepers are used to cover the roof for preventing them from getting hot. There are planters at each level for creating green curtains, and these planters are watered with drip irrigation. Trees are planted on east and west side to protect the walls from direct sunlight. Water sprinklers are fitted on the roof to wash the solar panels and solar water heater tubes to keep their functioning at optimum. Also, it is used to cool down the hot roof slab in summer if required. Organic kitchen waste is composted using three-pot method and then used in the kitchen garden. Five-pot water filter is used for filtering drinking water. There is no RO filter in the house. Double height is used in drawing room and dining area to prevent heat buildup. Most of the lamp shades are made from bamboo grown in the same premises, and other lamps are sourced from local handicrafts. Door handles are also made from wood harvested from the same premises. Most of the wood used is salvaged wood from demolished old houses. Cane furniture is used to minimize the use of wood, and cotton upholstery is used in place of rexin to keep it eco-friendly. Minimum lawn is grown in the garden as it consumes a lot of water, fertilizer, and pesticides. Contour of the premises is done in such a way that all the water is collected in a pond. From there, it percolates in the ground. Walls of the house are having cavities specially made for birds to nest. Also, insects are provided housing by making holes in the pieces of wood. So, this was the visit to Eco Home in Surat. Thank you for watching.